Thank you. As I was saying, I don't like intermissions. They ruin the magic, you know? They yank you back into reality. One moment you're in a world of music and glamour, and bam, you're surrounded by tourists. Crinkling candy wrappers and nattering on of the lack of women's restrooms is cruel. Oh, it's a power bar. I have a slight blood sugar issue. I have to eat small meals every day or else I get jittery. I remember my wedding day. It was, the ceremony wasn't until 4 PM, and I hadn't eaten breakfast that morning.
Oh, I do, I do.
Are you surprised to hear that I was married? Well, there you are. You shouldn't go making assumptions about people now, should you? I'm a very complicated person. I have to pee now. I'll be back, I promise. But in the meantime, you can listen to the beginning of Act 2.
Have one god, impossible! Wow.
I am so sorry. That song was not from the Drowsy Chaperone. That was from another musical entirely. I have a woman who comes in and cleans for me once a month. Can you say that? I have a woman? Anyway, she cleans the things I absolutely refuse to clean. She's quite good, although she has an annoying habit of cleaning my records and then putting them in the wrong sleeves. Even though I tell her, no touch records, Carmela, no touch records. I suppose if I spoke to her in complete sentences, she'd stop touching my records. Anyway, that song began Act 2 of another Gabelstein show, The Enchanted Nightingale, a degrading piece of chinoiserie about an emperor who is told by a magic bird to marry his American elocutionist instead of his betrothed, and he ended up building the Great Wall of China. Huh. A slap in the face to 4,000 years of Chinese history. But it had some wonderful tunes. Did you recognize Beatrice Stockwell as the American lady? Yes.
Wonderful.
And, did you see Roman Bartelli as the emperor? Yes, he was a man of 1,000 accents. All of them insulting. Now, Act 2 of the Drowsy Chaperone begins with this. A haunting lament from a depressed bride. She stands on a balcony, bathed in the pale blue light of a sympathetic moon, which is ridiculous because it's the middle of the day. Now, when you're listening to this, try to ignore the lyrics. It'll be hard, but try. They're not the best, and the tune is beautiful, and it truly communicates the bride's state of mind. Just ignore the lyrics.
I put a monkey on a pedestal and try to make that monkey stay. And he did for a time, but he needed to climb and with other monkeys play far away. He left his jacket his tiny rusty cup.
going to pour myself a brandy.
Come, my little monkey. Come, my little monkey.
The melody is so simple, it just floats in the air. And I must admit, I do get a little bit misty thinking of that tiny jacket lying on that pedestal, its long sleeves dangling on the floor. A little Busby Berkeley, a little Jane Goodall. And that's another thing I love about musicals. When a character's in a crisis, they sing and they dance, which is so much more interesting than just whining about it. And that's another great thing about musicals in general. Oh, you see, this is what I'm talking about. This is life. You manage to be happy for 5 seconds. And then all of a sudden, something starts ringing.
Hey,
Shall I have the pews moved now, madam, or shall I wait until morning?
Okay, I'm going to stop here, because I don't want this number ruined by a ringing telephone. Here we have two volatile performers who have slipped through the cracks of time. They are Noel Fitzpatrick and Ukulele Lil. I know nothing about them. I suppose Ukulele Lil played the ukulele, although she doesn't in this show. I've tried to find out more about them. I've checked all my books. I've even tried the internet. But all my searches have ended with photographs of Tiny Tim's autopsy. Anyway, they're both charming.